Good morning, everyone. Myself, Rubina, in front of you, back with a new video. Today, in this video, you will be learning how to install Java software on your Windows desktop. Okay, let us see what are the tools needed for us to install the Java software on Windows. So, the tools that you will need for installation, before installation is, you will be requiring a Pentium 200 megahertz computer with a minimum of 64 MB of RAM or 128 MB of RAM recommended. Okay, this is a basic need. Then the other things that you require is the operating system, either it is Linux or Windows or Mac or any other thing. Okay, the basic operating system is needed. Then the Java JDK file, and finally the Microsoft Notepad platform, Notepad editor, where we write the Java programs. Let us begin. How to install, what to do. So for installation purpose, what is required for us? How to install? For installing the Java software, first of all, you need to visit the Oracle website where we can download the basic edition, the standard edition of Java for learning purpose for the beginners. Okay, once you download it, it will be available to you inside your downloaded files, where you have this downloaded files. This is the downloads folder where you have all your downloaded files. So my downloaded file is over here, which is JDK 14.0 version, and which is an application. Now which I run, once I start running or run this application, I need to just click the next button to complete the installation process. Once the installation is done with the next and so on, the next property is, yes, this I will be explaining to you live on the system, but before that, let me have a overview of it on my presentation. Very, very important is in Java, just the installation of the software is not enough. We are required to set the environmental variables as well. We need to set environmental variables. For that, you need to right click the PC. Okay, when you right click the PC, you will be selecting the properties. Click onto the properties option. When you click onto the properties option, something like this screen will be appearing to you on your desktop. From that, now you will be next selecting the advanced system settings. Okay, when you click on to this, inside this advanced setting, you will be having something called as environmental variables. Click on to this environmental variables now. Another dialog box will be appearing to you where the heading of this dialog box will be represented by environmental variables. Now, inside this, we have two small pop-up windows, which is user variables for Windows 10, and the other one is system variables. Okay. Inside this system variables, first of all, you need to click onto the new option. When I click onto this new option, you need to set the new system variables. Now, right now I am setting my new system variables. The name of my variable I have taken as Java Home, and I have selected the path by browsing the directory. Where is my Java actually installed? It is installed in C drive, program files, Java folder, and the particular version where it is available to you. Once I browse this, I will be getting the path of it. I will be clicking onto the OK button now. That was the setting for the new system variables. Now, once I set the variable name, the next option is to set update the system path. To update the system path, now if you see onto my screen, there is something called as path. Okay, there is a variable named as path. Now I will be editing this particular path. First, I will select the path variable. Then I'll click onto this edit button. once I click onto this edit button, a small another edit environmental variables window will be open to you, popped up to you. There you will be clicking onto this new option. When you click onto this new option, a new variable setting option will be highlighted to you, where you will be writing percentage java underscore home percentage backslash bin. Okay, this is the path that I am giving to my Java platform. Once I do this, my path and the system path has been updated and the system variable has been set up. Okay, I'll be clicking on to this OK button. Not only on this OK, first OK, second OK, and the OK of the environmental variable. Once I do all this, the next option is to test my configuration, whether whatever the settings I made to my system variables and I updated my path, is it done properly or not? To check that one, I will be opening my command prompt. So this is my command prompt window where I will be navigating into my C drive where my actually Java software is located. So there I enter a command called as echo percentage java underscore home percentage. Once I do that, the version, the current version, the files, everything will be displayed to you into your C drive. Okay. Once I do that, again, I will be testing for the version whether my Java C command is working or not. If it is working, it will be representing you or it will be returning you with the version. With the active version of the Java, it is 14.20. Okay. So this is the way how we set the configuration and all. Now to understand this, let us go on to the live. So what I'll do over here is I'll show you the. So now onto my this PC, I'll right click, go to the properties option. There I will be selecting the advanced system settings. Inside that we have something called as, under advanced option, we have something called as environmental variables. Inside the system variables, first of all, I will be selecting the new. In this new, you will be writing here Java home and also browse the directory where it is actually located to you. Okay, for the time being, I'll just show you how it is done as I have already done with my configuration. So I need not do again, just I'm typing for you to make it understand clearly. Now, for setting the variable value, I will browse it, browse into my directory. So inside my this PC, my directory is C directory. Inside that program files, the Java folder, there I have something called as JDK 4.0. Okay, I'll click onto this OK button. If I click onto this OK button, again it will be set. It the path has been already selected. As I have done it already, I need not do it again. See, you can see my already updated version of Java Home. So I won't be updating it now. I'll just simply cancel it. So my new system variable has been set up. The next option that you need to do is set the path. So click onto this path. Now you need to click onto the edit option. In this, what you will do is you will go to the new option. Over this new, you will be writing whatever I have in my first line, percentage java underscore home percentage backslash bin. Okay. And after doing that, what you do is it will be appearing at the last of your line, last line. Okay. Last line. I'll just show it once for making you understand very, very clearly. Percentage java underscore home percentage backslash bin. Okay. Once I do this, I'll click onto the OK button. So it will be done repeatedly twice.
So my variable will be at the end of this line. At the end, that will be the last command in my window. So what I will be doing is I will be using the move up button and try to move it up like this. It is moving up, right? So I will take this and drop it near the first line over here. First line of my environment, edit environmental variables will be nothing but percentage java underscore home percentage backslash bin. Once I do this, that will be done. I'll select onto the OK button, but I need not do it again as I have already completed this settings. So I'll just delete it. I won't be updating it to make you understand I have done it. So I'll just delete this option. That's it. And I click onto the OK button. I'll click onto the next OK. I click onto the next OK. I need not set my OK button also, as all the commands has been done previously. Now, after this, what you need to do? You need to go inside your command prompt, CMD. Open your command prompt. So your command prompt has been opened. Over here, to come out of the two directories, make use of the command called as cd space dot dot. Or cd dot dot. After this, you will be writing something called as echo. Echo is the command. Okay. You will be writing echo space Java C. Java C has been echoed. Okay. Now I wanted to test even the version Java C hyphen, whether my Java C command is working or not. I want to test. Java C is not recognized. If this is the case, what you will do is exit from the command prompt. Again, go back to your this PC. Yes, again here only. Environmental variables. Over here in the path, edit option. My bin is already on the top. Okay, I'll just click on to this OK button. OK. OK. Once I have done this, again open the CMD command. Echo, sorry, echo whatever you have typed inside your Java underscore home percentage. Okay, enter it. So it will be showing you where is it directly actually located. Now you will be applying your Java C command, Java C hyphen. Version. So it has given me the version, right? So that's it, friends. This is the way how we install and set up the environmental variables to your Java software. Hope you like the video. If you like the video, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share it with your friends. Thank you so much.